I'll be honest, fam, I've been in a Weeknd type mood. After my gym sessions, I lay down in the massage chair and I put on my Weeknd playlist. And I've been listening to a lot of Kiss Land, a lot of Trilogy, Beauty Behind the Madness. And with y'all, I've been checking out albums I never heard before. But I say, you know what, for this little short amount of time I have, let's check out the Weeknd's EP that really holds a special place in a lot of us Weeknd lovers' hearts. And like I said, it's a little odd, but I'm not down, I'm not sad, everything's going great, I'm not heartbroken, I'm just in a great mood. But if you never heard this EP or these songs before, you're welcome, because this is special. So before we begin, just know you guys, every Thursday, guaranteed, you will get a new album reaction from me when you subscribe. But if I have more time on my hands, like you're probably seeing this video not on a Thursday, it's because I'll take more time to check out different albums. Don't be afraid to comment below your favorite album, because if it gets enough likes, if it gets enough push, I'll definitely check it out. It's your boy Jakar. Let's start with track number one from The Weeknd, My Dear Melancholy, Call Out My Name.
We found each other. I helped you out of a broken place. You gave me comfort. But falling for you was my mistake. I put you on top. I put you on top. I claimed you so proud.
Song, I just wanted to go back to this one part that really, really hits. I want you to stay even though you don't want me. Why can't you wait till I fall out of love? That's such a tough predicament. That's such a tough thing when you're the one that's in the opposite position, where it's like, why can't you break up with me when I'm fine, when I don't love you no more? You gonna leave me or fall out of love before me? No one wants to be in that position. You feel me? Like, we was both in love. Something happened. Were you out of love before me? And he came in here just saying, I know that this is a big, big Billboard type song, but I need y'all to really listen to the lyrics and really sink into the lyrics. Don't just listen to the grand thing, because this is why I love Even Reaction, you know, this type of vibe, because it makes me appreciate certain aspects of certain songs even more, even when you've heard it hundreds of times. Call out my name. I don't even have to give it a big presentation. I'ma say it for the channel. 10 out of 10 song.
Wow.
Track number two, Try Me. that instrument is right there. But I always love that part of the song. See, it's a story. It's a story.
Be the best I ever had. Baby, God, remind me.
About to come back, I believe. I love synths. Don't you miss me, man. This is actually a song that I skip. I don't listen to Try Me. Everybody got their own vices, their own red flags, toxic traits, yellow flags, whatever that they've dealt with. Feel me? But for me personally, I've never wanted a girl that's in a relationship. Any girl that I've been with that is with somebody else after me, it's never been a type of like this where like, please try me, or like in that conversation, I want you back. Don't you miss me over him. I feel like, I don't know why, everybody's different, like I say, but just for me personally, when I see a shawty with somebody else, then I just root for them to be happy. Like, on some real, I'm just like, yo, be happy. If shit doesn't work out no more and she's single, then hey, we could see what happens. You feel me? But when she with somebody else, boom. And that's different if you just stumble upon a shawty that's in a relationship that ain't tell you that she in a relationship. You feel me? And you guys kicking it. I'm saying a woman like this where she broke your heart and she moved on already, bro. And you still want her. Nah. Nah. Like, she's already gone to the next dude. Just let her be. But this is also why we love The Weeknd, because he's so vulnerable to let us know a deep side of him. I know people like that, and that's okay. Everybody's different. Just know that you want to protect your heart. You feel me? Don't be hurting yourself. Don't be hurting your mind. Don't be hurting the other individual over stuff like that. Still a solid track still. Oh, well, yeah, this is my song, actually. Track number 3, Wasted Times.
Wasted times. I spoke with someone else. She wasn't even half of you. Reminiscent how you felt. And even though you put my life to hell, I can't seem to forget about you. I want you to myself. And now I'm asking for you.
Part. I love this.
Catching feelings. I ain't got no business catching feelings.
ever been in a breakup while still having love and care for the other person, you're gonna feel this song. It's hurts. This is not a good song to listen to when you're in that environment. It doesn't really help you. Just only thing that's great is to know that you're not alone. There's plenty of people that feel the same way. I remember that part so deeply where he's like, wake up. I don't want to wake up if you're not laying next to me. When you sleep with the same person for so long, it's so weird to sleep by yourself. You feel me? It's such a weird thing because you have dreams of the person. You start to wake up and you start to touch. I literally was sleeping with a pillow to remember, like, because I was so used to tossing and turning and holding the other person. So those things just is fucked. He says, I don't want to wake up if you ain't laying next to me. I was in such a down state, fam. I didn't wake up. Like, I was sleeping a lot. I was not active at all. I did not look like this. You know? I didn't have this. And I'm glory to God, you know, I made it through just all that. But I could relate. I know a lot of people can. That's why this is one of my favorite songs off this album. Once again, 10 out of 10 track.
Wow.
Track number 4, I Was Never There. This beat's one of my favorite from the Weeknd. What makes a grown man wanna cry? Wow. Could definitely get disguised by this powerful beat. Sometimes I find myself walking into the gym blasting this shit, but this is a depressive song. He's talking about pretty much like, hey, I could just end my life. It was like I was never there regardless. This is why it's toxic, because when really she just moved on. She moved on to somebody else. It has nothing to do with your value and your worth. If you're not right for someone else, you may think you're not right for anybody else. But you got to look around and see, yo, there's plenty of people finding love. Like, there's plenty of people, and no disrespect, beauty's in the eye of the beholder, but some people be looking funky out here, and you'd be like, what the fuck? They even got some love, and that could do something crazy to you. But just know, your match is on the way. Like, it's all good. So don't be taking your life. Don't be hurting yourself. Don't be stalking and possessive over someone else. But I understand, when you're an artist, you gotta let out your most vulnerable. You can't hold back, because if you hold back, you can't create at the highest level. The vulnerability of the Weeknd, that's what makes him so great. That's what we love. Track number 5, Hurt You. He went from sadness to anger.
Now I know relationships my enemy, so stay away from me. I'm warning you.
Is he warning you?
He
he man now.
The void with every man you meet. Mm. Cause you're upset with me. I'm warning you.
It could be true, but
all the nights you slept alone, dry in your arms. And all the nights you thought about taking your life. Cause if it's love you want again, don't waste your time. Mm.
But if you I always like this song. From anger to understanding. I don't want to hurt you. Maybe we not good for each other. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe you're right. But that's what every nigga want. To be the number one dude in a woman's life. Like, not number two, not number three. Fuck these other dudes. Before it was 100% toxic, I want to be the number one guy, call me up. But now this is half. If you notice the lyrics, half of him is the old Weeknd, being hurt and everything, and being little, being spiteful, prideful, being a little too vulnerable and too transparent, you know? This other half finally is saying, no, I don't want to hurt you. So he's thinking, maybe I do have to let this woman go. Cause I'ma just keep hurting you. That's why he said, cause of me, baby, throughout the entire song right here. Everything that was down, cause of me. And that's what sometimes everybody realizes. After the heartbreak, you start to think, damn, I wasn't so perfect after all. Or damn, you know what, maybe it was me. I'm blaming this person the whole time. You get to look back and think about what did you do or what didn't you do. Brought the sirens back. Let's go to the last track, fam. Track number 6, Privilege. This song's so beautiful. It's scary how he put 6 songs together so perfectly to show a breakup from a guy's perspective.
Enjoy your privileged life.
Suffering. I don't want to hear that you're suffering now. I was here when you were suffering. Addiction to lust, I'll just fuck it away.
I'll be back to my old ways. And I got 2 breaths to take the blues away.
He's saying, I don't want to hear that you're suffering. And it's muffled, but that's what he's saying. Know how many times I've heard the song Privilege and how many times I've heard My Dear Melancholy. This was my favorite time ever hearing Privilege. This is my favorite time ever hearing Privilege. I've heard it so many times, but I don't know, it's different. I think it's finally because I really am looking at the lyrics and I'm more intentional because I'm with you guys. It's not just playing, you know what I'm saying? It's just me in the car with y'all. And Damn, that's a beautiful ending. I wanted to say one part from the last song real quick before we go to final thoughts. Enjoy your privileged life, because I'm not going to hold you through the night. We said our last goodbyes, so let's just try to end it with a smile. I don't want to hear your suffering. I don't want to hear that you're suffering no more, because I held you down when you were suffering. And that is the spitefulness of us men. But sometimes you got to say, fucking just let it, you got to let it be known to a shawty, because we know other men. We are men, so we know other men. Everybody has their own thing. And that's why when women just categorize men into one box, that's not the right thing to do, because some guys going to curse in front of a woman. Some guys going to say, hey, don't talk like that, you know, woman around. Some guys are going to put their hands on a woman, and some guys will never dare. That's not in their blood. That's not in their code. And so what I'm saying is, since we know that and we see that and we hear the stories and we know that, that's when we tell a shawty, when it's the last goodbye, we say, all right, I don't want to hear that you suffering. I don't want to hear, because over here on this side, you didn't have to deal with some of the things that you could potentially have to deal with. On that side, yeah, I'm not perfect. Like, he's talking about with the drugs, with the alcohol, with the lust, and with all those things. Yeah, I'm not perfect, but there's certain things that I would never do to you. When you were suffering, when you was down, I was there. So that's what he's talking about. In the beginning of the album, he's very transparent on his emotions, how down he is, how much he wants her back, and on himself. But at this song, he flipped it to the transparency to be super blunt and just real. You've been privileged. And honestly, if we gonna keep it a stack, he's the Weeknd. And some of us men know that we're elevating. Some of us men know that we're good men. Some men hear, I wish I was with you, from other women. Some men see the world around them and they can say, hold up, I'm not perfect, but I'm a good dude. And I've given you a privileged life in certain ways, shape, or form. So now he's finally saying his goodbyes and saying, yo, enjoy that. But it's so toxic. It's so unhealthy. He said, I'm going to drink it away. I'm going to take the pills. I'm going to sleep with all the women to blind it. And that's what we do as men. We don't take the time to just be in isolation and heal ourselves, work on ourselves through these type of things. He said it's going to help him. It doesn't. And this is the toxic cycle with the Weeknd. Man, listen, my dear Melancholy, for final thoughts, if I had to choose my least favorite song, it would be Try Me. If I had to rank the songs, it would be Wasted Times, I Was Never There, Call Out My Name, Privilege, Hurt You, Try Me. That's how I would rank it. Man, I'm really happy I listened to that with y'all. Haven't heard a lot of these songs in a long time, but I've been in a great Weeknd mood. So I'm probably going to bump Kiss Lane right now while I head out. But you guys, let me know. Comment below, what Weeknd album do you want me to do next? Whatever one gets the most likes and push, I'll do that one. And we'll just go from there, because we have a lot to get to when it comes to the Weeknd. And let me know how y'all feel about the songs. Let me know how you feel about some of my thoughts that I had throughout this entire album, if you could relate. And last but not least, don't forget to click that subscribe button below if you like what we got going on over here. Just good vibes, good music. And I got plenty of other playlists as well that's just giving you some good soul talk and experiences. It's your boy Jakar. See you guys on another video. I'll talk to y'all.